Given x equals 1 as a 0 of the polynomial function f of x equals 16x cubed minus 24x squared plus 5x plus 3, determine the rest of the zeros. Recall the zeros are the values of x for which the function value equals 0. Let's keep track of the zeros below. Again, we are given x equals 1 is a 0. Even if we weren't given this 0, we could graph the polynomial function and determine the real rational zeros by determining the x-intercepts of the function. Let's take a look at the graph. Notice the polynomial function has three x-intercepts, which indicates all three zeros are real. And notice we do have an x-intercept at 1, 0, verifying x equals 1 is a 0. Notice when x equals 1, the y-value or function value is 0. And now let's work on determining the two remaining zeros without just clicking on the x-intercepts. Because x equals 1 is a 0, x minus 1 is a factor of the polynomial function, and we can write f of x in the form of f of x equals x minus 1 times a quadratic factor, which we can find by dividing the polynomial function by x minus 1. Let's do this using synthetic division. Recall to perform synthetic division, we use the 0 of 1, and then we list the coefficients, which are 16, negative 24, 5, and the constant is 3. And just as a reminder, if x minus 1 is a factor, we should get a remainder of 0 when performing synthetic division. To begin, we bring down the 16, then multiply by 1. 16 times 1 is 16, and then we add. Negative 24 plus 16 is negative 8. Multiply by 1. Negative 8 times 1 is negative 8. Add. 5 plus negative 8 is negative 3. Multiply by 1 and add. And notice we do get a sum of 0, indicating the remainder is 0. And because we're dividing a degree 3 polynomial by a degree 1 polynomial, this remaining factor is degree 2, and therefore the 16 is the coefficient of the x squared term. The remaining factor is 16x squared minus 8x minus 3. And now to find the remaining zeros, let's see if we can factor this trinomial. If it doesn't factor, we would have to find the remaining zeros using the quadratic formula. And if it does factor, it will factor into two binomial factors. This trinomial is a little more difficult to factor because of the first term being 16x squared, not just 1x squared. Let's use the factors of 4x and 4x for 16x squared, which go in the first positions. Next, we need to find the factors of negative 3, where the sum of the inner and outer product is equal to negative 8x. Let's use the factors of negative 3 and positive 1, and try a factor of 4x minus 3 and a factor of 4x plus 1. The inner product is negative 12x, the outer product is 4x, and notice the sum is negative 8x, verifying the factors are correct. And now to find the remaining zeros, we need to set the factors of 4x minus 3 and 4x plus 1 equal to 0 and solve for x. For the first equation, we add 3 to both sides and then divide by 4. We have a 0 of x equals 3/4. And for the second equation, we subtract 1 on both sides and divide by 4. We have a 0 of x equals negative 1/4. Let's record these below. Because we have a degree 3 polynomial function and we found 3 zeros, we know we have all of the zeros. Let's go back and verify these using the graph. Notice the x-intercepts are negative 0.25 or negative 1/4, 0.75 or 3/4, and 1. These are the zeros of the given degree 3 polynomial function, verifying our work is correct. I hope you found this helpful.